Hello and welcome to a new episode of IO Revisions 2 part 18. Last episode we have read the diary from Mutsuki and have found out some very interesting things. For example, that she really really liked Tsukasa, who is Enlil, the guy in the sport car. And that she probably is dead because she is the one of the storage devices used for storing everything in Babylon, if I understand it correctly. Let's read for one. While I'm stretching and rubbing my stiff neck, drowsiness suddenly assaults me. My parasympathetic nerves are stimulating my body to try to enter a relaxed state. Mutsuki created a tool called Enigma to decompress data from a person's dreams. And I need to have a dream to stop this confusion. I need comfortable sleep. I think this was around the time we were admitted into our private elementary school. We were at the park together when we saw a rabbit.
Hey,お兄ちゃん。醜いウサギの子は大きくなったら綺麗な白ウサギになれるかな?
In
retrospective, it is really, really bad that you said this.
あれ?でも、醜いアヒルの子は?あれはアヒルが白鳥になれたんじゃない。最初から白鳥の子だったから白鳥になったんだ。へえ、そうなの?
Everything is your fault.
DMCA?
違う。全然違う。 DNA だよ。
DMCA. This is something which I will get probably at a later point. DMCA is right. Should DMCA, I think. We got a sleep strike or something like that in America. Yes. I thought it was a random question that just suddenly hit her, but it was a sign. I didn't realize in the slightest that she was that seriously worried about something like that. Come to think of it, that might have been when Mutsuki started becoming a shut-in. She escaped to cyberspace in order to become her ideal self, but wasn't bound by her DNA. In that case, it was my inconsiderate words that were the trigger for the death of many people, yes. The words "you have no delicacy" that I've heard from several girls now pierce my heart. Lem doesn't answer. It is also nearly new moon, so she should be really, really weak. She gives me neither a confirmation nor a denial. Only silence follows. I reluctantly change the question.
Hinata?
Tsuki wa ieru?
Is she on the other side of the moon?
Tsuki? Mieru?
What does this mean? I have no clue. So it is the day, and if it's the day, I can't see the moon, but it is there. The same with Mutsuki. Probably. Right then. Okay, so it's the same thing with Hinata's dreams. If he closes his eyes, he sees a different world than the real world. And then there's also the Babylon world. So there are already three worlds. Maybe. Dude. Yes, so now it is 2032 or something like this. 32? Yes. I can't see the moon, but I can see Sakuya, who's gotten her cheerfulness back.
いや、食事自体は美味しそうだから何も文句はないよ。だったら何？どうせ作るんだったら作り終わってから起こして欲しかったな。何言ってるのよ。起きてすぐじゃ胃が動いてなくて消化に悪いのよ。それはそうだけど、もしかして自分が料理してる姿を僕に見せたかったの？
Damn it, she got me. I went to say I'm not going to eat now, I am bet she'd give me a death glare so powerful that I wouldn't be able to withstand. What a dangerous trip. It also kind of feels like a scene from a happy household. But is this really okay? Do we have a dignity or a right for this?
Huh?
No, I'm quite sure I don't. Sakura leaves the house as she says this. It seems she's going to home, to go home, to change her clothes, then go visit Midori again. I ask if I could accompany her, but... She said that, since it's come to this, that's what I need to do. But how? Say I've been treating on Mutsuki's privacy could be an understatement. If we were normal siblings, then that would be an area that she'd never let me go or know about. Is it really a good thing for me and Mutsuki if I learn anymore? After this, Mutsuki might face a grim conclusion in the future. But as long as I will get her back, I think everything will resolve itself eventually. But Mutsuki might be a hacker. And what's more, it's also possible that she's a drug dealer. Like Enlil. I'm scared of facing that result. What if the act of getting her back backfires and leads to her going to jail for a long time? And her social status plummeting? Could I be a bit? I grab the stuffed rabbit with trembling hands. But the fluffy sensation is somewhat nostalgic. At the very least, there's got to be something I can do to clear the way for a better future. And one of his things is not to turn a blind eye to something as serious as a crime, right? That stuffed rabbit just silently stares back at me with round eyes. At that time, Lem's words come flashing back.
Hinata? Tsuki wa mieru?
I think as I embrace Moon Bunny.
Tsuki. Kyou wa shingetsu da. Tsuki wa mienai. Demo mienai dake de kichinto itsumo to onaji ichi ni sonzai shiteru.
Really slow, Hinata.
Sou iu imi nano ka?
The things you can see with your eyes and in and of themselves are not the truth. If I add deduction after deduction, I'll definitely know where Mutsuki is. That might be what Lem wanted to say. So she's always on the other side? A short while later, I head to the town. Because it's still bright enough out, I look for a place where I can observe that back alley without attracting suspicion. I find a suitable cafe to use and break out a pair of binoculars I brought along. When dusk approaches, suspicious men in groups of 3 to 5 gather from an unknown location. Some of them are wearing the black jackets with a fairy on it, while some aren't. With my cell phone in one hand and my binoculars firmly grasped in the other, I wait impatiently When will Sin appear? When will the deal begin? When should I call the police? Truth be told, I considered informing Cyberforce about this a little while ago. But if I did, I'd probably be sticking my nose in a place Mutsuki didn't want me to look at, though. That's why I want to wait until the bitter end for the ringleader to come out. That's why I'm stalking them out. Is Sin really Mutsuki? Will you appear? There's a lot of movement going on, and the cafe manager's glare is getting quite stern. I'm very uncomfortable. And as of now, I ordered my third drink, but... A big man with a jacket, which is black, who's leading several fellows appears. The black jacket, yes. His unifying force is clearly beginning to change the movements of the people around him. From what I can see of that man's behavior, there's almost no doubt he's the dealer. But no matter how hard I look at that person, I don't see any hints of Mutsuki. So Sen isn't my sister. I still don't know. There's a possibility that this is a different person, or that he is Mutsuki's underling. I prepare for the worst, telling myself not to be surprised by anything. But it seems like individual guilds are finally about to go down. If I don't call the police now, they might escape. Despite that, while looking all over the place with my binoculars, I spot something unexpected. There's a guy with a cap covering his eyes, hiding behind some roadside trees, glaring at the dealer. It's Yoshida? I instinctively stand up and head for the register. The manager is clearly relieved that I'm leaving. As I say this, I place down 2,000 yen bills. The manager raises an eyebrow, then catches on quick. I run down the stairs and look for Yoshida. He's not at the roadside trees anymore. I want to stop him before it's too late. I don't consider myself Yoshida's friend by any means, but due to the recent developments, I can't think of him as a stranger either. Maybe it's because I feel me and Sakuya's future might be somewhere in Yoshida's and Hiragi Midori's fate. I desperately strain my eyes, but... Are these gunshots? That was the roar of a gunshot. I wasn't the only one who heard it. Me too. Posterboys on the mainstream stop walking and turn toward the sound, just like me. Wait. Why does he look like Hinata? Yoshida rapidly but deliberately advances while shooting a pistol. Ah, this is Yoshida. His face shows no emotion. Yoshida's target is clearly the large drug dealer. But his followers are taking the bullets, so Yoshida can't reach the dealer. It feels like I'm watching a scene in a movie. My legs won't move as if they've begun being glued to the ground. It feels like the time has stopped, but it also feels like it's flowing at a high speed. An odd sensation. My heart is pounding. My legs are trembling. My teeth grind together. Before long, when bullets stop coming out of the gun, Yoshida looks down as if he's looking at a strange object. He stands dazedly in place. So your ammunition is gone out. Black shadows swoop down on him in succession. Yoshida pulls the trigger of a now empty gun over and over again, as if he can't do anything else. That's why I... In that instant, centripetal force takes over in a world with Yoshida and the drug dealer into the center. Figures of people begin to run in all directions, scattering like baby spiders, and Yoshida seemingly losing strength and collapses on the road. I can see what appears to be bruises on him, but he's not bleeding. He literally just fell over. Immediately afterwards, an ambulance, detectives in business suits, and blue uniformed police officers come rushing over all at once. The instant he's handcuffed, Yoshida's eyes meet mine. When he does, an apparently lonely yet satisfied smile rises to his face. I'm sure I'll never forget his eyes for the rest of my life. I'm powerless. I can't do anything. I couldn't stop or save Yoshida. My hands and legs had no strength, and I couldn't call him a friend, either. I'm a coward, trash, utter scum. I can't look Midori in the face now. Why am I alive? It'd be better if I just died. But I don't even have the courage to do that. I really am hopeless. It's because I'm like this that Mutsuki abandoned me. In this dark moonless night, I just condemn myself over and over again. But I prostrate on the ground and punch it so many times that I can't even tell anymore if my fist hurts. Would be calling at a time like this. I check the caller's ID to see it's from Yayoi sensei?
Hinata da na. Jikan ga nai. Ikkai shika iwanai kara yoku kiite kure. Ato de seishiki ni tsutatsu ga aru to omou ga. Kyouka gakuen wa ashita kara mukigen de heisa sareru. Shitsumon wa nashi da. Mai kara monda ni natte ita keredo. Konya.
The full moon, new moon. Goosebumps cover my whole body. I remember what happened with Yoshida earlier.
Oh no, it's Pyotides again. 私もこの悲劇を止めるためにできるだけのことをする。
先生、僕は一体どうしたら？
強く生きろ。そして大事な人を守り抜け。それだけを考えるんだ。日向ならできる。私の信じている日向なら。
先生。先生。
泣くな、日向。私だって今まで必死に我慢してたのに。崩れたくなるじゃない。
先生。
先生、relying on me?
お互いしっかりやろう。いい。約束だよ。
はい。わかりました。弥生先生。
ありがとう。じゃあ、またな。
I don't have a willpower to press a button to hang up. So many hands was holding the cell phone just dangles.So my hand that's holding the cell phone just dangles. The world's reality is beginning to crumble. Where's the world I believed in? How much time has passed? I see Yumi who's looking at me with concern. I don't know what I should do. Strangely enough, when I see her looking at me like that, my emotions dry up with me.My mind is so conflicted between talking to her about everything and resisting those impulses that I end up in emotional paralysis. When I really would like to have some of your medicine, Hinata. As I am ill.Or a little bit drowsy. Not drowsy, but I'm not feeling too well. Let's say this just now. Oh, Yumi. I'm not the one you should be thanking. Sakura's the one who made it. I have no power whatsoever.
それに、あの、Yumi は、ひなた君のこと、好きだから。
Huh?
海でも他の人の役に立つって、ひなた君が教えてくれたから。だから、ユミ、ひなた君のこと、好きだよ。
ユミ。ユミ。
よしよし。
Wrapped up in Yumi's arms, I confess my complete powerlessness, my stupidity, my utter hopelessness. I don't keep a single event about today a secret from her.When I think about it carefully, this is a truly terrifying, ghastly spectacle. Why am I telling Yumi, who is so frail, all these horrible things? But I can't stop myself. Yumi just listens to me talk the whole time. Words cannot describe just how grateful I am to her for that.
Yumi もね、いっぱい悲しいことあったけど、いっぱい泣いて、全部忘れちゃった。
Yumi...
大丈夫。 生きてるんだからなんとかなる。生きてるんだからまだまだこれから何でもできる。ね。
Yumi.
What the hell am I doing? You must not weak at all. She's way stronger than me. I've just been escaping.
ありがとう。僕も、もう大丈夫だよ。
よかった。
At that time, I noticed Yumi is carrying an ill-fitting, unrefined video camera. She's carrying a large tube around her back. Is there a tripod in there?
これですか?
Yumi notices my stare and smiles sweetly at me. How can she make such a pure expression?
新月の写真を撮ろうと思って。
あ、新月って見えないんじゃないの？
もともとは新月は真っ暗な見えない状態から鎌のように細い光が見える月のことを言うんです。
あ、そうなの。でも理科年表じゃん。
そうですね。科学ではそう決められてるんだけど、でも新月という漢字は理科年表より前からあるんですよ。
I can't believe myself. Common sense had blinded me. There's not just one meaning to everything. The context is different when that changes too much.
Yumi?
はい。何ですか？
今晩は理科年表的な新月であって、漢字の歴史的な新月じゃない。つまり月はやっぱり見えないんだけど。
What if you can?
ユミ。
あ、そうでしたね。
なんだよそりゃ。
やっとひなたくんが笑ってくれました。
え？
いつも一緒に笑っていられるようにしましょうね。
I don't know, but she seems really, really suspicious to me.More than anything in this whole story.
一緒って。
ダメですか?
Even a thing with a leader. Wouldn't surprise me if the leader was Enlil. Or something like that. Or Ea or some other important person or he. Does she understand the meaning of what she's being saying for the last minute or so?
Ah, yeah, そんなことないよ。そうしよう、そうしよう。
よかった。
If you think she's been saying don't have any strange meaning but are said naturally and mean exactly what they say, then she should find a way to package up that natural airheadness of hers and send it to all who are unable to put their fears to rest every day. And yet she's completely unaware of her amazing ability.
新月の写真はないんですけど、月食ならあるんですよ。
あ、それってこの間の？
はい、そうです。すごくよく撮れてるんです。そうだ、ひなたくんにもプリントあげますね。ユミ、いくつか持ってるから。
Imagine them being really really different photos.
あ、ありがとう。
Okay, this seems normal. It's amazing red color.That could take your breath away. The moon was shedding blood. Maybe it was in this bloodstained light that the world changed. But judging from Yumi's innocent expression, she doesn't see anything ominous about it at all. I'll take good care of this photograph. Like the letter I got from Dad. I won't lose it.
大事にするよ。
はい。
I feel that the smile is a treasure that should never disappear from this world.Just then, the remaining mysteries of the crossword puzzle pop into my mind.
そういえば、ユミはネットとかコンピューターとか詳しかったんだよね。
え？まあ、お姉ちゃんやリーダーほどじゃないですけど。
あ、そっか。でも、きっと大丈夫。他のキャラクターに扮して会話するチャットって、なんていうか知ってる？
なりきりチャットのことですか？
なりきり？あ、それだ。
もしかしてまたクロスワードですか？
うん、そうだよ。ユミは本当に僕の女神だ。
そうですか。では失礼して。
ああ、そうか。
わーいわーい、クロスワードが解けた。
OK。 Im Spark, the mind of other people, human, and I perform our usual folk dance. No music, no observers, only me. Just she and I dancing to our heart's content in the dark veil of the night. Day 2032, 25th of May, Cluster 15, Blue Day. By the end of the day, my fate had gone amiss. Mysterious group suicides, summoned by the new moon. Shooting spree in business district, high school student arrested. Narcotics, the sinister shadow behind the scenes. Kyoko Academy accepting bribes. Staff rounded up. Unforgivable, Xerge losing Academy as test site. A scenario that brings death. The Usher tragedy. Incidents and more incidents. Nothing but incidents. Bloodshed, disasters, tragedies. Every day these incidents appear in the newspaper and on TV. Take her into your arms, like a fine bow. The board chairman of our closed school answered in an interview, all I was doing was following instructions. Most excuses are utterly ridiculous. The school I was going to was really that kind of a place. Van Mutsuki was much smarter than me to not even try to go there from the beginning. And the rest of us, who had lost our school and our colleagues, were cast out into the cold. Many of them have immersed themselves in Babylon, having gotten hooked to the net, but we? I haven't felt like going back after that incident. That kind of world did attract me, and I'm a bit concerned about what happened to Hinata, but I can't understand scenario Ashura. It operated on wicked intentions, or if not that, then mysterious intentions that defined human intellect, who are played with in the palms of her intentions. That's what it feels like. Even with things going the way they were, Dad couldn't come home. All he did was send an email that said I can't come home back from work. It's the same with Mr. Kawahara. Even though he tried to pit Sakuya and I against each other so much, it all became meaningless in the end, given that he's not here to interfere. And what if some outrageous incident happens at their company? Sakura says this. That's all I can say. If those two went through the same thing as Izumu, Tsukasa and Mutsuki, couldn't you say they are similar? The charm of a net, because of that, their love burned way too fast. In the end, I don't know what the Adidas connection to Mutsuki was, because I lost my head due to the incident with Yoshida. I missed my chance to track down the drug dealer known as Sin. But what good would it have really done? Even if I managed to get just the two of us together, I have absolutely no guarantee that bluster and recklessness would be enough to successfully interrogate a brutal criminal. I got way too deeply connected to the series of incidents. I never could have predicted that I would have ended up in the situation as a result. After all, suicide induction project, a brainwashing method that gnaws at the mind. Narcotics and shootings. Who is mystery person X pulling the strings behind the blood feeds? New type of narcotic spreads on campus. Hinata was a student? Suspect, Aoi Hinata. Formerly Kyoka Academy High School freshman. Metropolitan Police Department, Biocomputer Division. Is there any information about Aoi Hinata being a drug dealer? The information was released because there was evidence and credibility to it, right? That's not true, is it? In the West, there's many examples of 12-year-olds who are heads of the street gangs. He wasn't in any club, right? Really? According to the records, he frequently skipped lessons, and he hanged around in your infirmary, correct?
何が言いたいんですか?
Did you and the suspect have a special relationship of sorts?
生徒と教師は特別な関係だというなら、そうかもしれません。いい死に巡り会えるかどうかは、子供の一生の問題ですからね。
Are you playing dumb?
そちらこそ、陰猥な邪推でお茶の間をにぎわせようというゲスな意図が見え見えですよ。
Let's try a different perspective, shall we? You're sticking up for the suspect right here at this moment because of the goodwill you had for him, yes?
ええ。それに、あなた方が呼んだからです。
You're fixated on the possibility that cracking was involved. Why do we have reason to believe that that's the case?
様々な可能性があります。それに対する意見を言うのは、警察の仕事であって、私がここにいる理由ではありません。
I see, then, if a suspect is watching this from somewhere, do you have a message for him?
そうですね。私は彼を信じているから、特にこれといって言うことはありませんが。
What would it be?
クソったれなメディアや見当違いのネットの意見、それは一時的にあなたを傷つけるでしょう。しかし、負けない勇気を持ちなさい。恥は一時、信念は一生。はい、ありがとうございました。
The attack from Enlil or Coat, Edok or Doror towards me was simply acidic. Cyberterrorism, nasty harassment over the net. The problem is that even Cyberforce is after me too now. The figure Coat who couldn't punch someone in his to save his life is now watched by the police? It's really unbelievable.
君を危険に巻き込むから言えない。
どうしてそんなことを言うの？私、ヒナタの役に立ちたいのに。
ありがとう。ここにこうして来てくれたことだけで十分に感謝してる。
ヒナタ。
I could surrender myself to the police and tell them everything, but if I did that, then I'd have to reveal even the stuff my sister wanted to keep a secret. I want to protect Mutsuki.
Mutsuki.妹を探し始めてから、すべてが狂ってしまった。
Yes, she caused quite a bit of chaos.
え？何を言ってるの？
おそらく妹は、重犯罪すら辞さない集団の中枢に取り込まれている。僕が今、こういう事態になっているのは、連中の報復なんだ。
それはそうだけど…
Are you defending them? Since about 2 weeks ago, since the day of the new moon, when those horrible tragedies happened, I haven't gone home. So it's the... Ah, okay, it's just the fifth. I've been wandering from place to place. Oh, it's not the fifth, it's the 25th of May. I've been wandering from place to place, from park through the whole town, looking for the invisible new moon.That's what saved my life. I only heard about this from Sakuya, but someone broke into my house. They broke through the deadbolt and tore apart my room and my room alone. They left a single bullet on my desk as a warning. It meant if you stick your nose where it doesn't belong, any deeper, you'll be shot with that bullet. On Monday morning, my name came up along with a report of many tragedies. I was so dumbfounded that I couldn't speak. Ghostbusters made me suspect, so I tried to run away.
一旦ムツキを探すのを諦めようと思う。
え？どうして？
永遠に諦めるわけじゃない。ほとぼりが収まるまで待って、準備を徐々に固めて、もう一回チャレンジする。でも、
どっかに行っちゃうの？
だから昨夜にお別れを言いたかった。
いやいやいや、私も絶対に離れないから。今までどんな寂しい思いをしてきたか分かる？
死ぬよりはマシだよ。
死んだ方がマシ。
バカ。
Dude. I look at my right hand in dumbfoundment. I wasn't thinking just now, but I performed an act of violence, something I never thought I'd be able to do, and I did it to someone I truly care for.
ごめん。そんなつもりじゃなくて。
Sucker holds her cheeks as she shakes her head. With this, I've taken a step closer to being someone who should be scorned.
それがいけないことなの。どうしてもダメなの。自分の身を守りきれるかどうかわからない。だから僕は昨夜まで守りきれる自信がないんだ。分かってくれ、さくら。いいもん。自分の身は自分で守るから。無理だ。そんな甘い相手じゃないんだ。頼む。困らせないでくれ。僕が寂しくないと思うか。僕だって孤独に満ち震えている。
That's why I... Sorry, Sakura, I don't have anything against you, but... This is the point... where we have to... Moon Age is 15.6. Okay. That's why I can't take her with me, no matter what. One of Sakuya's usual smiles rises to her face. That's right. An almost unbelievably calm smile from her, and then tears pour from her eyes.
Sakuya. Muri suru no wa yameyo. Ima naitatte ii janai ka. Boku tachi no kokoro no naka ni wa itsuka futari de waratteru ie ga kichinto aru kara. Dakara.
Our wish is by no means overambitious. If fate exists, then even if we part now, we'll definitely see each other again. Because you're there, and I'm right here. Because our emotions are the same. While holding her trembling shoulders, I vow that I'll definitely come back. I never let you go through the same thing I did after I lost Mutsuki. For an instant, Yayoi Sensei's face appears in my mind. No, too dangerous.
サクヤの、お父さん、エクサクのセキュリティはしっかりしてるはず。いろいろあったけど、お父さんはサクヤのことを愛してくれてるんでしょ。そうだね。だから、分かった。心配してくれてありがとう。
Sakura takes a terabyte disk out of her bag.
レムちゃんからの贈り物。レムか。これがないと絶対にクロスワードは解けないんだもん。だって。レムがまた昨夜のところに来たのか。うん。一回だけね。ひなたのこと心配してたよ。
そうか、レムが。じゃあね、元気にしてるんだぞ、ひなた君。病気しても怪我したとしても許さないからね。絶対絶対、無事で帰ってくるんだよ。わかった。約束する。じゃあ、指切り剣舞、嘘ついたら針千本飲ます。そうだな。
I have no confidence I can stay in one piece, but at times it's more right to tell a white lie instead of giving the harsh truth. The me who learned that may have, sadly enough, become an adult. There's no need to ask, Inagaki. Just thinking of you. I enter the clue I got from Mayumi in the horizontal box in the lower right hand corner. Cross cosplay chat is where you dress yourself as a character. Down clue. A neurotransmitter frequently found in narcotics.
Yes.
This, well, admittedly don't know the answer to this one. I shouldn't be hard to find out. I head for the usual net search engine. Some common neurotransmitters are acetylcholine, norepinephrine, and dopamine. Got it, alright, time to type it in. Dopamine? Just one more letter. I could probably guess it from what I have now, though. Let's try rearranging things. Genders? Nah, no way. Sendirk? Sounds like a surname. No, this isn't working out. Maybe I'll have better luck with the first word. Nehjing? Negging? As in neggy? Aging? Nginghak? Sounds like a license plate on an old woman's car. Ah, forget it. None of us feel remotely close. I do feel like I probably could figure it out for what I have, but just to be safe, I'll get the last letter. With that in mind, I head for the middle. There's only one pair of across and vertical clues that where that intersect, because it's not chained to anything. I can't put any words there.
Mateo.
I excitedly take out the disc. Only this is the data Sakuya got from Lem. With this key, I'll be able to unlock the last area. The system automatically reads the disc, and then the area of the middle section of the crossword, a word with just four letters appears. It shares the S in cactus. The ancient Tibetan name for the name of Tibetan Buddhism, holy ground, whose name means Buddha's land. I immediately search for it. Lhasa, known as ancient Tibetan writing as Lhasa. Down clue. To illegally usurp a server's root authority. To crack. Hacking, hacking, hack, crack, cracking. The search results are various dead slang words, but just one of them catches my eye. That one is to really usurp a server's root authority to crack. Okay, this is the word now. But why should I? Do I need anything? Oh, I don't need it. What if it is important to write down the other clues? Tammuz or Binaf, if it really means anything. Vein? It's also a clue. Maybe there are no important things. No. The fairy suddenly flutters about. I try to cheer myself up. Anyway, let's start with the second word since it looks less complicated than the first. I try rearranging a bit, and the result is. Dragons? Is this some strange net slang for dragon? Come to think of it, Inagaki mentioned a guild or two when we were in Babylon. Maybe it refers to the name of a guild there or something. At that time, I begin to change around the letters in my hand. I switch the D with a G. Grains, wait. A train moving RNV guns. It's the hanging guns. That's it. So it is the roof of a school? Or the roof of a building? If it is hanging guns? Moving on to the first word. It's okay. I could have probably done it myself, but yes. Ignoring all the ridiculous ideas I had before, I moved several of the latest around. Hanging? Could it be one on a hunch, I moved the last N and put it between the A and the G to find. This is Hanging Gardens. Something related to Babylon. The Hanging Gardens. A nostalgic scene appears in my mind. That's right. That's what we call the gardens on the back of the school roof. Perhaps the final key to meet Mutsuki again is there. If that's the case, then what should I do? Once the flower beds would have been multicolored and in full bloom, at the very least up until half a month ago there would have been a supervisor that looked and took care of him. But since the school's been closed, they've been neglected and are now a mere shadow of their former selves. Shadow now. The garden has withered and fallen into ruin. Despite that, it seems the roses and raspberries have withered the lack of attention at the best. As they are still living, even if only barely. What does Mutsuki want me to do here? What did she want me to show? Even though I solved this puzzle, I still can't find the last puzzle piece. The most important something. I can't help but feel that way. Sorry? In the withered garden, small reddish purple petals of a flower blow by like a whisper of the wind. Red clover? I try approaching them. All that's in that corner are three-leaf plants that are spread out, surrounding small flowers. They are red clovers. Like in the story, so... Is this the place where Mutsuki... died? This is where the medicine Sakura gave me came from. I recall another nostalgic sensation. I crouch down and take a long hard look at the purplish red small flower when... My childhood memories begin to reborn along with an electrifying sensation hitting me like a lightning bolt on the head. Memories that I've sealed away up until now. It was 10 years ago. When we were brought for the first time by our dad, who worked at Kyokak Academy as a short-term contract teacher. And those, we found a place in Kyokak Academy that suited us best. It was the Hanging Gardens. It was a place very close to the sky. Full of flowers in full bloom. Faced with this wondrous sight, we instantly let out shouts of joy. Felt the same, but was too embarrassed to say it out loud, so I just looked up at the sky. The moon? Okay. Mutsuki said this with a serious expression. When she said this, Mutsuki closed her eyes. I'm sure it was her imagination that was doing all the seeing. Unable to say anything, I look up at the sky again and calmly observe the windswept clouds while being bathed by the warm sunlight. Just then, Mutsuki looked down the stairs. There was a cat napping in the shade, while bathing itself in a pleasant wind. That is not how it works. Mutsuki began to wave a story out of that fanciful dream. Take hide and seek, foot racing. We played a whole lot of games there. But in the end, the last thing we got absorbed in was...
クローバ
ー。いっぱいあるじゃん。
違うの。四つ葉のね、クローバーを探してるの。
四つ葉なんて、そんなの本当にあるの？
あるよ、絶対に。お兄ちゃんも一緒に探そうよ。
At times like that, Mutsuki would absolutely never change her opinion.
四つ葉のクローバーは滅多に見つからないから、幸運をもたらすシンボルになってるんだよ。
へえ、幸運が欲しいの？じゃあ、今は幸せじゃないの？
違うよ、幸せだよ。
そんなもんなのかな。
そうだよ、幸せな時にこそ悪魔をつけ入ってくるんだから。だから虫よけに、
魔よけ。
そう言ったでしょ。
言ってない。
言った。
言ってない。
言った。まあそういうわけだから探そうよ。
Didn't I give you a charm like that already? Although I thought that I crunched down and started searching. While we looked, Mutsuki told me some things about clovers.
クローバーってね、まれに5枚や6枚のやつも発見されててね、18枚のものまで見つかってるんだって。5つ葉は金銭上の幸運、6つ葉は地位名声の幸運、7つ葉は最大の幸運を意味するとか言われてるんだよ。
あ、つまりはさ、それって突然変異ってことだよね。
ドッペルゲンガ
ー？ Wait, has she said doppelganger and there's no fluctuation?
違う、全然違う。っていうか、ほとんど似てない。突然変異。なんて言ったらいいのかな。変わり者？
普通じゃないってこと？
まあ平たく言うとそういうことかな。ところでさ、なんでそんなに詳しいの？
I was half interested and half amazed by that knowledge.
本で読んだの。
電子ブックか。ムツキは本の虫だからな。
To Mutsuki, who was prone to illness and rarely played outside, books were her best friends. Anyway, I'll help Mutsuki look for a four-leaf clover at first. No matter how hard I looked, I couldn't find one. So I gradually grew tired of it and began playing other games. But Mutsuki continued to search for the clover alone, and eventually... She let out a small cheer. I ran over to her and looked over that small four-leaf clover.
どれどれ？これが四つ葉のクローバーなんだ。
It was the first time I've ever seen one. It looked like a round cross.
お兄ちゃんは？見つけた？
いや、まだだ。でも、帰るまでには絶対見つけてみせるから。
For some reason, I couldn't help but want to one too. Before I know it, I was seriously peeling my eyes for a four-leaf clover, but... Mutsuki was making a crown or a necklace out of the purplish-red clovers. As she waved them together, I continued to search earnestly. I can't find it, I can't find it. I can't find it, I can't find it. I can't find it. The sun was setting. It was finally time for us to go home. But... Feeling bitter and like all my efforts had gone to waste, I said this with a sigh.
So, じゃあこれあげるね。
Mutsuki presented her four-leaf clover.
でもこれは
いいの。だってお兄ちゃんが大好きだから。
A carefree smile rose to Mutsuki's face. When I saw that expression on her, I felt my nose start to rip.
よし、じゃあ今度来るときはお兄ちゃんがムツキの分を探してあげるよ。
本当？
任せろって。
I meant it from the bottom of my heart.
じゃあね、じゃあね、おまじないしてあげる。
おまじない？
ムツキ placed the clover on top of my head.
これは？
あのね、妖精さんっているでしょ？
いない。
もう。いるの、いるの、いるんです。
はいはい、わかったわかった。じゃあそういうことにしておこう。
うん。でね、妖精さん、例えばフェローリとか。
それは車、フェアリーね。
ーとかいろいろいてそこら辺をオロチョロしてるんだけど、普通の人の目には見えないでしょ。
うん、そうだな。
でもね、頭に四つ葉のクローバーを乗せると見えるんだって。
へえ。
ねえ、どう？妖精さん、見える？
見えるわけ。
No way I could. I was tempted to give a straight tremendous response, but...
これでお兄ちゃんに見えなかった四つ葉のクローバーが見つかるようになるといいね。
Mutsuki
was wearing the ref a necklace of clovers, said this with a white smile. And I see, so that's it.
見えたよ、妖精。
本当？
これできっと、ムツキのクローバー見つけられるよ。
よかった。約束だよ。
あ、じゃあ。
指切りゲーマン。
But even with my headgear and necklace, I could never find a clover. The day Mutsuki left, unable to be my feelings of remorse, I went up to this roof alone to look at the sky. My hands was a pressed four-leaf clover. Beyond the tip of my outstretched hand was the high sky. The world was so far away.
Where?
I am here.
Mutsuki, I am here.
Missed opportunity. The sun was shining. Despite that, I couldn't feel its brilliance or its heat. I couldn't see the moon. I couldn't see anything with my eyes. So close then. The world reflected in my eyes was so transparent that it was almost sad. From the day around onward, I slid off a part of my memories. I fragmented the information, cut off the link. I closed my eyes. I detached my heart from the world and from myself.In other words, that's how it is. The final piece has come together. This is the place where it began, and at the same time the place where it ends. The end is the beginning, and the beginning is the end. And in the end, I never found a four-leaf clover. And I never will. Is that true? Did Mutsuki want me to know that? That there are things that you cannot find, even if you search for them? Does this also refer to Mutsuki herself? Meaning Mutsuki really is dead? No, that's impossible.I get irritated and decide to start looking again. For the hope of in the shape of a four-leaf clover. It's quite difficult to look for a flower in darkness, but in a short amount of time after I begin, immediately. I'm taken aback with shock at how quickly I found it. Is it possible to find something you've been looking for so long in such a short time? The story of a bluebird, maybe? But...You found it because it was all along next to you?
四つ葉のクローバーはめったに見つからないから幸運をもたらすシンボルになってるんだよ。
Is that it? What Mutsuki was seeking was modest, ordinary happiness? They slip into your everyday life, and therefore you won't notice them very easily, but if you pay close attention, you find that small bits of happiness all around next to you.The four-leaf clover I'm pinching in my hand, maybe the remains of such a modest dream that was so difficult to realize. That of my sister, the genius. My sister whom no one could catch up in the end. My sister whose heart fell to her despair so easily. My sister who wasn't understood by anyone. My sister who was pure and innocent for this world. My sister who I hated and loved.
そうか。そうだったんだ。ムツキ、やっとわかったよ。
The side of Mutsuki that I've come to know is currently wrapped up in sadness and misery. And so she sent me a message through her autonomous program that she created herself. Where are you? I am here. What complex emotion could these words be full of? I finally figured it out. They are extremely complex and chaotic, dark and bright, white and gloomy emotions that cannot be expressed in words. Because they've been internally separated in two.I might have finally obtained the threat and to mutual understanding. Hesitation, confusion, and earnest wishes. When the very end came, Mutsuki hit me with all she had. But it's all too late. For a long time I shut my eyes, covered my ears, closed my mouth, and hid in a shell. I didn't know anything. I wasn't concerned with anything. I was nowhere. All I could do was secure myself in one spot. I didn't know.No, I was pretending not to notice. I averted my eyes from the truth. Before long, the clouds covering the sky clear up, revealing the form of a divine wound. My phone chirps, I received an email. The sender is... Mutsuki? I found you. You're right there, aren't you? There's still time. I'm not too late after all. I immediately sent my response. That's right. I'm right here. I have also found you. I've certainly found Mutsuki's heart. And one day I'll find Mutsuki herself. I hold the clover up to the sky. Tears pour ceaselessly down my face. We are not of sorrow, nor of joy. A more pure and primal emotion is producing them. It's been 2 years since Mutsuki disappeared. I'm crying for my sister for the first time. Beyond the four-leaf clover, I'm up by my tears. It feels like a small fairy traversing in front of the full moon. That's right, I found you. And this is the first ending, or the first route, route A, version 0.1. Okay, let's talk about some things. What are my opinions so far? Even if route A isn't supposed to be the most interesting route, it was a really good build up. Everything seems plausible until now. I like the character sprite, I like the background, I like the OSTs, the opening. Very interesting ending, for sure. Are the characters blend? I don't think so. I liked everyone, I think. They have a lot of personality. Maybe not. Maybe there are visual novels where they have a lot more personality, but I don't know, I like the characters. Have I some theories for something? I don't know. I need to read further to get some theories or some ideas. This OST sounds straight like one thing of one OST of Umineko, or Umineko mixed with Higurashi. The strings sound like some of Dice OSTs, and the electronic part sounds like, I think it was CTS, ZTS, or who was it, XCL, I don't know. So up until now, very interesting story. Will get a lot more complex with this, I know, but Ja. I need also to complete some of my idea sheets and the timeline before I start with Route D. Which we can do in the spot, but just until the point where we choose a character and opening. Ah, this is a instrumental version of Oneken, the opening. Or a mix of some OCs and the opening. Very cool. And very, very big shout out to the people who created this. Game. Because until now I'm quite entertained. Ah, and the voice acting is also great. I think I don't do the voice actors until now, but we are doing a great job. And it is certainly similar to things Ever 17 and Remember 11 made, the directors made. Also similar to Never 7 in a lot of things, which I am not saying, but yeah, it's something like a mix of every game they have created, I think. And also some elements of from other visual novels. Maybe took some things from IO. The only problems I had with the game was, I think, or is the thing that if you tap out, that it is the windows are on the top left side. And this is the worst part. Otherwise, I don't see any problems with the end. Very good work, Register. Okay. Now we are coming to this. A equals one. Fragmented individual root episodes have been restored. Thank you. Update. New material added to extra. Okay. I have saved, okay. Playing lock, CG, moving music, keyword, defrag. Let me look. I think I should not defrag now. The next step would be to start root B. 0.1. Okay, for that we can go into a new game, log in.
Ware warabe no toki wa kataru koto mo warabe no kotoku. Omou koto mo warabe no kotoku.
Skip this, I think. Nothing important happened. Or will be added. So we are skipping it until we see the choice feature. Maybe it would be interesting to see what happens if you read this with a context of knowing the game or Route A. But okay, Let's save. And choose a young woman followed by companions. And you are our companion for this route, I think. Let's see if the route, if the openings change such as the universe built by the noble gods. Okay. Dream scene and waking, another reality frame beyond the mirror. Where the lions live, we have to open the vows to near where the old exists, but not die, I think. Okay. Nothing new, I think. Now is the question what role Hinata would play. This route. Put out, put out. Wait, is it a different color? Is the staircase in different colors? Thus begins the revision of the world. Okay. Not gate. We have a different text box, I think. And this will be the point where we stop for now. I think the video is long enough. Moon age is at 16. Date should be the same where we started or something similar. Route B, cluster 00. And yes. We have a playtime of nearly 20 hours. For now. Yes, we have no red text box like we can see here. And I hope you enjoyed the episode. It was really and cool end. Very emotional. And I'm already very intrigued by what will happen in the next episodes. I hope I will see you in the next episode. And stay healthy.